Today, we'll use limits to derive the formula for the area of a circle. To comprehend the concept of a circle, let's begin by examining polygons, starting with a triangle and gradually increasing the number of sides. The polygon begins to resemble a circle more closely. If the number of sides approaches infinity, the shape will become nearly identical to a circle. Leveraging this property and the limit values visible on the screen, we'll demonstrate the derivation of the formula for the area of a circle in today's video. Let's consider a polygon with n size. Focus on the green triangle with a side length of r and an angle of theta. Since there are n such triangles in this polygon, each triangle's central angle will be 2 pi divided by n. Applying the formula for the area of a triangle, which is half times a times b times sine theta, to the left green triangle, its area becomes half times r times sine 2 pi over n, or when simplified, half times r squared times sine 2 pi over n. What we have found here is the area of a single green triangle on the left. As this polygon is composed of n of these triangles, the total area of the polygon becomes n times half times r squared times sine 2 pi over n. Now, let's imagine increasing the number of sides of this polygon to infinity to make it a circle. We can take the limit of the verb formula as n approaches infinity. In other words, as n tends to infinity, we get the limit of n times r squared over 2 times sine 2 pi over n. However, in this limit, the factor r is independent of the limit operation, allowing us to pull out r squared over 2. This simplifies the expression to r squared over 2 times limit of n times sine 2 pi over n. To find this limit, let's multiply both the numerator and denominator by 1 over n. This transforms the expression into r squared over 2 times limit of sine 2 pi over n over 1 over n. Further, multiplying both the numerator and denominator by 2 pi gives us r squared over 2 times limit of 2 pi times sine 2 pi over n over 2 pi over n. The 2 pi in the numerator is independent of the limit calculation, so it can be moved out front. This simplifies the expression to 2 pi times r squared over 2 times limit of sine 2 pi over n over 2 pi over n. And the factor of 2 in the numerator and denominator cancels out. Hence, the expression becomes pi times r squared times limit of sine 2 pi over n over 2 pi over n. Now, let's substitute 2 pi over n with theta. As n approaches the infinity, theta approaches 0 due to the denominator n approaching infinity. Rewriting the expression with this substitution, we get pi times r squared multiplied by the limit of sine theta over theta as theta approaches 0. In this context, the limit of sine theta over theta as theta approaches 0 is proven to be 1 in another video, which you can explore through the link in the upper right corner. Consequently, the expression simplifies to pi times r squared. In conclusion, the area of a circle with the radius r is pi r squared. There are various methods to prove the formula for the area of a circle, and today, we demonstrated one of these approaches using limits. Similarly, it is possible to derive the formula for the volume of the sphere using a similar method. In the upcoming videos, I'll present the processes step by step. If you have any questions or opinions about the content of the video, feel free to leave a comment. If you found today's video informative, please consider subscribing and liking. Thank you so much for tuning in. This has been your math guardian, Alex.